Ja, hallo und willkommen zu meinem Let's Play. I am Ein H. Hans und today we'll be flying for the Fatherland, for the Germans, in the Messerschmitt Bf 109. Ja. I know, you guys thought it was bad when I was doing Russia. Oh no! You've not seen anything yet. Ja. So let's get cracking. Let's see here. We're going to be flying in Kursk, which it doesn't say, but it's actually 1943. We're going to be flying the Messerschmitt Bf 109 G6. I don't know what the difference is between the G2 and the G6, but 6 comes later, so I assume it's better. Place of birth will be Guten Tag. Yeah. Where they make the strudels und the Hosen that I am wearing right now. Yeah. Okay, after a difficult offensive winter battles in Ukraine, the front lines have established themselves again in 43. A significant Soviet bulge in mein Hosen has developed at Kursk, followed by a German bulge, yeah, in the Oralbogen. Oral, yeah. At the time, the German High Command had decided to crush this bulge. In a pincer operation from north and south, the most modern equipment, including new heavy tanks, will be brought, Panzers, up to support the offensive. The operation has already been delayed twice, and the Soviet forces in the bulge are very strong and fortified. Luftflotte 1, 2, 3, 4 will support the northern thrust, from Oral. Hosen. Main tasks will include winning air supremacy, close support, and raids against the Soviet supply system. Okie dokie. Here we are, July 4th, 1943. It's a little bit after noon, good weather, clouds it somewhere, and our friends from the strike group are performing an attack in the Trosna area. We'll be attacking Russian artillery positions and protecting our bombers. So we'll be flying under Obsolete Eater, Lieutenant Andreas, Humpty Dumpty Coolman, Obstil Forward Traeger, Major Kaufman, and I am obviously Forward Hans. Hans, yeah! Hans Gunther. Very good. Okay, so let's take a look at our plane. Looks like we're going to be carrying drop tanks, so this may be a long mission. This is the Bf 109, the Messerschmitt Bf 109. It has gigantic cannons, it has automated prop pitch, automated radiator control, everything's automated, it flies itself, and there's a bird face. So that's fun. Bird face costs extra, you gotta pitch in for the whole thing. No CD player though, not in this version. It is a long flight, holy crap. Looks like, yeah, we're gonna be escorting I'm assuming that all of our flights, because we're not gonna be centrally located for this. Kursk was a very important battle, though. Some say it was the turning point of the German-Russian section of the war, and I am inclined to agree with them, as are most people. I don't know if that's even disputed. Regardless, it primarily was a gigantic tank battle, one of the greatest tank battles in history, and the Panzers were fausted to death. Wait, let me get my silly hat on. Drop it. Sorry. Okie dokie. So, you know, I'm speaking of German. After saying how easy this plane is to fly, I might be experiencing some Schadenfreude, yeah. Because I could get my butthole kicked in pretty quickly here. But, again, the Bf 109 is a beast of a machine. The one issue that I have is the gun sight is a little fucking whoa. Don't know why they put it over there. Not my problem. So again, we'll do the takeoff ourselves, and then we're gonna be on autopilot for quite a while now. And a German autopilot, I would trust because the Germans are such good engineers, yeah. Also, when you start the engine and begin takeoff in a German fighter plane, for some reason, this is mostly true only of German fighter planes that I've encountered, hit the brakes, because they're locked on. So if you throttle all the way up, your plane will just pitch forward and explode. Which is, while funny, is also fatal. So that's not good. The plane does not have aileron trim. I know that, as I think only American planes had aileron trim. But this one has much better rudder trim than any of the other planes of similar time periods. I don't know if that's a retractable tail wheel. I don't think it is. I'm not going to worry about it too much. It's not going to slow me down. So yeah, there's our flight of bombers that we'll be escorting. And I'm going to go ahead and stick it on autopilot now and fast forward for a million years, because we got a ways to go. Hopefully we'll see some cool tank formations. Again, same deal with the difficulty setting. I'll only be able to see my own plane and my own map path on here. If I could figure out a way to turn only allied planes on, I probably would, just so that I could get an idea for where my wing is and such like. Although, you know, the situational awareness, a lot of people were asking me to turn on the tags for planes. You know, they're little, I don't know if you've seen them before, you probably have, almost every other person who plays this game plays with them on. They put little floating tags that you can see, like, that plane would have the words BF-109, etc. in blue floating above it, and enemy planes would have similar tags, but they would be in red. And it makes enemy identification and friendly enemy identification... Whoa. 11 o'clock low. It makes all identification trivial, because you can see where everybody is and who exactly they are at all times. And I consider that to be a relatively important part of flying a plane in this time period, is the ability to identify the other aircraft in the area and maintain situational awareness. It's extremely important, and it was extremely difficult as well. So, since we are encountering enemies, I think I'm going to drop my tank. That goes, yeah. And that'll allow us a great deal of extra speed. I'm just going to stay on this guy's tail for a little bit now and see where he goes. I'd also like to see if he has his tail wheel retracted, because I don't want to be the only one with my tail wheel hanging out. It doesn't look like he does. I'd also like to know what the F that is. You know, that does not look like my friend. I'm not saying it's my foe. It does not look like my friend. So we're probably going to be seeing yaks, hurricanes, lags, maybe. I think that is a 109, actually. In fact, I don't know where our bombers went. There they are. Don't hit me with your drop... That fucking drop tank might actually hit me. Okay, I think it missed me. No, there it goes. Yeah, that thing will kill you. And we've just been notified of fighters at 11 o'clock low. We got some guys going into the shit. I'm almost redding out already. Let's see here. I'm gonna see who he pulls up. There we go. What? I saw a lot of shadows. I didn't see what they were attached to. Where's the sun? So they gotta be under me. Unta me. Da unta gunta! I don't know where the fuck I am! Oh god, my wings are gonna rip off, though. I know that much. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and regain some of that altitude. I don't know what that guy was diving after. Again, this was, you know, right now, if there were tags on, I would see where enemy planes were, how many of them there are, how far away they are from me. And, that's no fun. See, the thing is that I like it when someone sneaks up behind me and murders me. I think that that's a good challenge. Yeah, I don't know how many fighters there were. It might have been as few as, like, one or two. But, there's the formation of bombers, or at least what I assume is our formation of bombers. Probably Stuka. Could be, Henkel 111s, or the like. Every speck of dust on my monitor. I want to shoot it down. So for armament, this thing has got some pretty heavy cannon. Hopefully we'll get to see that in action. I'm seeing some of the planes. Probably one of my buddies. At level flight, this guy will fly at around 3,000 meters. It can do probably around 500 kilometers per hour in level flight. So whatever this guy is, I'm going to get in formation with him. Okay, he's a 109. So I didn't hear anything about anything being killed or any such shenanigans. So there we go. The fighters are buzzing the bombers right now. And they're keeping their sweet distance. So yeah, I'm going to make sure a couple more checks behind me. I don't think there's anybody back there. If they are, they're like under me. Unter me. The Untergunter. So yeah, we're going to focus on trying to get enough altitude to hang out with these dudes. That guy's going to die. Whoa, I think that's one of them. Might have been. That is a 109. What you want to look for with 109s? Yellow and square wingtips. Okay, so the leader of that bomber formation killed that one fella. And I think that these might be bad, bad men right here. These might be Ivan. It's just like when I was in grade school. It's the motherland versus the fatherland. Not seeing anything going on. I don't know if this thing has a mirror. Oops, it's got a map. It does not appear to have a mirror. If it does, I've got the wrong key to map to it. Yeah, I don't know about these guys here. Now, the one thing that you need to be careful about is that you do not want to mess with your prop pitch in this plane, because it's automatic, and if you mess with it, it will stop being automatic. It'll be manual again, and I don't know if you can ever get it back to automatic. But we're gaining speed and hopefully getting closer to whatever these guys are. You know, those look like 109s as well. I don't know why they would be turning back, though. Or why they're doing that weird flippy-floppy thing. There were quite a few incidents of friendly fire from all of the air forces in World War II because of poor identification. Yeah, I think these guys are just some cowardly 109s heading home. But it doesn't really matter. As long as I don't run out of fuel. I don't know what the fuel consumption is like in this beast. I imagine it's pretty strong because of how powerful the plane's engine is. I should probably be messing with the mixture. We're gaining quite a bit of altitude here. Do-do-do-do-do! Climbing the plane height. We're gonna climb even faster now. Whoa. Okay, let's go investigate that guy. Because those two that I was looking at, those were my bros. And yeah, I was on course with them too. But what are you, good sir? Good sir, what are you? That's another 109. Alright, so I'm feeling more confident about my friend and foe identification in this setting, having played the Russian campaign previously. It seems like some of our guys are still fighting, though. Pardon me. It was a good cough. Though I don't know where they would be. I assume they would be down this way, towards the target. And I know what their return path is. Don't know exactly what their target was. I think they said it was a bridge? I don't know. It sounds like they're still fighting, though, so I'm gonna... Where's my fuel gauge? Let's see if we can find a fuel gauge. It won't be very... What is that? Liters. So that's gotta be my fuel gauge, right? It appears to be dynamic. The little needle there is, moving. So yeah, we're doing good on fuel. Don't know what any of these other things mean, though. Those three things there, I'm sure they're important. They're radioactive, for fuck's sake. I don't know what that means. But I also don't see anybody out here. Big open sky. We're flying a little low. Typically, you want to stay above 2,000 meters. This one does not have a supercharger or water injection. I think it uses some magneto settings or something like that to go faster in a pinch, but don't know what they are. Oh, maybe it's, is it the... There's one of these planes where you throttle all the way down and then do the water injection. If you don't, it will, like, hurt you, but it's obviously not this one. Fighters at whose 1 o'clock? And where are you? I really wish there was, like, a where the fuck are you radio thing. Okay, so something's been completed. Don't know what it was, but good for it. I'm proud of it. Yeah, they're still fighting somewhere. And my autopilot wants me to go home. But I'm gonna go ahead and head this way, because I assume that this is where the bombers and stuff are. Yeah? One of them just said target destroyed. That would lead me to believe that they are just now at their target location, so... That would be just on the other side of these clouds. Something's going down. And my engine's overheating, and my plane is shaking in the cloud layer. Laminar effects at 1,000 meters. I thought I just saw something. The radiator in this thing is automatic, so all you have to do is throttle down. I don't see anything. Except for... Are those trucks? Fighters at who's 12 o'clock? I want to see what these are down here. Those are trucks. Oh, hey! And a jerk with a machine gun. Well. Oh my goodness. Okay. Somebody's plane just crashed right there. And none of our guys just went, help, Hosen. So it couldn't have been a German, but what the fuck? Who the hell were they? Let's go take a look, shall we? Let's go see if we can find any identifying pieces of wreckage. Was it three? No, it couldn't have been three. I don't know what that was. Well... I suppose we could go strafe those trucks. That sounds like fun. That machine gun that was shooting at me was not designed to shoot at planes. That might have just been an MG, or not an MG, but the Russian equivalent of an MG-42. I think that little burr right there was where they were. I think. They're very small, so it's a little bit difficult to see. If that's the case, we should be able to get a good run at them. Yeah, why don't I spend a little time trying to locate them before I start some kind of fucking attack run on them? That's not where they were. Okay. I've lost them. Hello? Oh, there they are. On gun sight view. Let's kill a truck, shall we? Yeah. That was not a very good attack run, but... Oh, hey, that gun's a little bit better at shooting at planes. I don't want to die out here all alone. The one other issue that I could see right now being a potential possible problem is one, some random jerks flying by and shooting me down, riding down in the altitude from like 2,000 meters, to one of these little guns here popping my fuel tank. Because then we probably wouldn't be able to go home. Alright, let's take another pass. Here we go. There we go. Now I got a nice, good line here. We had one. Yep. Alright, so... enemy cars. Always a good target. You can go home back to base and brag about that one. Even if we didn't do our real mission, protecting the bombers. That siren noise that you're hearing, that's the notification that the flaps are in combat position. It's very nice for me, someone who locks his flaps up all the time. Alright. They want us all to go home, so I think I'll probably do one more run here. And start heading back to base. Which will be a long flight. Settle down. Settled. Whoa. I'm pulling. Alright. Don't get greedy. Don't get greedy. Fuck you guys. There's some artillery there. Not really going to worry about it. Let's get a vector to base. 300. So we'll head out that way. Dickhead. That one was pretty close. But mostly random and inaccurate fire. I was wrong about the heading. The heading is this way. Whoa, okay. Oh, no! Oh, no. No, 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 no. Is that fucking flak doing that to me? Okay, if we're spilling oil... what about my fuel? Down to... uh-oh. My engine just got popped, and obviously the inside of my cockpit as well. Fortunately, none of my gauges were hit. Jesus, look at that. Well, the gun sight's useless now. Engine's overheating, yeah. Fuck. Alright, I'm gonna turn the radiator all the way on. Let's see here. We got a ways to go before we can cross the line. I'm gonna head in this exact direction right now. Keep the engine... oh no, it must have lost all of our oil. Is there a thing for oil pressure? Did we lose all of it? Oh, that little compass thing is nice. Well, it looks like we're able to maintain speed. My engine just cooled down. I think we'll be okay. Yeah, that was just some fucking flak that hit us. One issue is, if we do make it back, seeing the runway. But yeah, I don't see any kind of fuel gauge here. I'm just... ooh. Those are lower than they used to be. Is that my... I hope that's not what I think that is. I hope that's not my oil pressure gauges. Whatever. Maybe those are the magneto things. Whatever it is, they're a lot lower than they used to be. I'm not going to let autopilot touch this thing. We're over the line, and I just got hit again. Wings okay? Yeah. It's just the issue of a couple of holes in the cockpit. Usually when you get shrapnel through the cockpit, it'll fuck up your gauges. But not so much this time. And we appear to be maintaining altitude and speed. So that's no problem. As long as I keep it on the same... oh no! Alright, our engine's out of fuel. That is a problem. I'm gonna ditch. There's plenty of fields around here, and we should be... in friendly territory. Is there a road here? There is a road here. Okay. I'm gonna do something a little bit weird. Get up a little bit of speed before we head down there. And... uh-oh, the road turns. Just my luck. Oh no, it turns again! I was gonna try to land on my landing gear, but I think we're just gonna do a belly landing. Unless... It's a bad idea to do a landing gear landing unless you have some sort of smooth surface. Because otherwise you'll just bounce until you flip over and explode. But... alright, I think we'll be okay. As long as the road doesn't suddenly turn again. I'd rather not do any more damage to the aircraft than that which has already been done. So if we could land on our gear, that'd be a nice way of apologizing to the engineers for what they're going to have to retrieve and repair already. Well, not a bad landing. A little bit of risky flying, though. No serious external damage that I could see. Yeah, just got popped in the radiator and I assume the fuel tank. It didn't say fuel leak, and that is my fuel gauge. It had to have had a fuel leak. Oh, is that a tear? And yeah, that was busted through. But regardless, we survived and we shot a couple of trucks as well. So let's go see how mad they are at us, if at all. Let's see here. Edar got one kill. Humpty Dumpty Cool Man got one kill. And Kaufman got four. Not every day brings glory, but you have fulfilled your duty. Yeah. And I got three vehicle kills. Let's see here. So that plane that crashed down near me was one of ours. It was a HE-111, one of the bombers. There's me. I just landed on that road there. Coolman was shot down there. Looks like he probably made it, though. Yeah, he's fine. And then there were some Yaks and P-39s flying around that we never got to find out about. I never saw them. Yeah, at this point, I turned around and apparently I was chasing down some... what the fuck? Oh, there were IL-2s flying around, too. Those attacked our fucking airfield. Damn it. Fortunately, it didn't look like many of them got away with it. So yeah, that was interesting. A bit of a struggle for our first mission, yeah. Either way, let's apply that and carry on. So Kaufman was awarded the Iron Cross, second class. Way to go, buddy. And we're going to be flying further south this time. Our bombers are preparing a nasty surprise. Russian factories protect the bombers. Hopefully I can stay a little closer to them next time. Anyway, join me next time for more IL-2. This is me, von Ein H. Hans. Wunderbar! Need I say more?